distinguished guests on the dais, guests before the dais, ladies and gentlemen. I must begin by saying that it's a great privilege for me to be here this evening at the launch of the Indian Vision Institute. Well, L.V. Prasad Eye Institute has very strong sentimental tones for me. And whenever L.V. Prasad Eye Institute had invited me, I don't think I had ever declined an opportunity to be there with them. And the reason for that is that the institute is named after late Sri L.V. Prasad Garu, who was actually my father's mentor when he entered the film industry. I haven't seen my late father actually rise and go right up to the gates to receive somebody or to see somebody off. I think one of the very few people whom he went forward to receive and also walked right up to the gate to see them off was late Sri L.V. Prasad Garu. And the reason for that is that he actually brought my father into the film industry, and my father always felt very strongly that whatever he was in every walk of his life, he owed it to Sri L.V. Prasad Garu. And therefore, it's an honor for me to be present here this evening when L.V. Prasad Eye Institute, along with, for very naive people like me, all that we know of the eye is that it is an organ of sight, helps us in differentiating between colors, brightness, contours, and so on. Probably a little more about how light would go enter the eye with the help of the lens, about the rods and the cones, and nothing more beyond that. I think it is only lately that we have come to realize the kind of drag that vision, or rather visually impaired situation, could actually have on the GDP of any country. We know that India has around 133 million people who are impaired simply because they do not have an access to a pair of spectacles, as many speakers have said so before. And another 25 million people probably who are blind, or rather visually impaired, because of the eye diseases, which could have been avoided. You know, you could talk of glaucoma and so on, which could have been avoided, but unfortunately the lack of awareness in people which is leading to this kind of a situation in our country. India has great scientific knowledge, she has great scientists. Australia, on the other hand, her center has been commercialization of research, and therefore the two coming together this evening I think is a great start, and I'm sure that India Vision Institute will go places in the future with very committed people like Professor Brian Holden himself and and Dr. Nageshwar Rao Garu, very committed to the growth of the Indian Vision Institute. Unfortunately, it is very lately that the uncorrected refractive error has received due importance as a cause of functional blindness and impaired vision. Optometrists have had very little opportunity to take part in the frontline elimination of childhood blinded fashion, where the academia industry would come together and ensure that we address the huge challenge that we have on our hand today. Throughout the world, of course, optometry has been a major provider of vision correction. But unfortunately, we strongly believe that health optometry has not reached communities that it should have reached by now. When we look at the ratio that should be existing between an optometrist and the population, in the developed countries it is said to be around 1:10,000 population. But in India, the ratio is alarming. We have one optometrist for 600,000 people. And in the rural areas, that is the villages, I think the numbers are that there is a huge demand, there is a huge need. And beyond that, I think we also need skilled personnel who will actually support this industry as well, just as Professor Brian Holden had very eloquently outlined the challenges that they face in this field. I think there's a huge potential for academia and the industry to work together now, and the time is right for it. We from the Ministry of Human Resource Development, we are willing to work with the Association of Optometrists in trying to provide the kind of skill development that is required and essential to support this field. We have a National Vocation Education Qualification Framework, which I was just...
దీని వెనక ఉన్నటువంటి ప్రధాన ఉద్దేశం ఏంటంటే మన దేశంలో ఉన్నటువంటి కొరత ఏదైతే ఉందో అది ఆప్టాల్మాలజిస్ట్ కావచ్చు లేదంటే ఆప్టోమెట్రిస్ట్ కావచ్చు ఆ యొక్క కొరతని తీర్చడానికి ఈ యొక్క ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్ ఒక ట్రైనింగ్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్ గా వారిని స్థాపించడం జరిగింది. ప్రత్యేకించి ఆప్టోమెట్రిస్ట్ విషయానికి వచ్చేటప్పటికి ఆప్టోమెట్రిస్ట్ అంటే సహజంగా ఆప్టాల్మాలజిస్ట్ అంటే కంటి డాక్టర్ కానీ చాలా వరకు కంటి డాక్టర్ చేసేటువంటి పనిని వారు నిర్వహిస్తుంటారు. తప్పితే సర్జరీ ఒక్కటే చేయరు అనేది మాత్రమే ఉన్నటువంటి అభాంతరం. అయితే ప్రధానంగా ఏంటంటే మన దేశంలో ఉన్నటువంటి ఆప్టోమెట్రిస్ట్ అంటే సపోర్టింగ్ పర్సన్ ఎవరైతే ఉంటారో ఈ కంటి చుట్టుకి సంబంధించి వారి కొరత కనుక ఒకసారి మనం పరిగణలోకి తీసుకున్నట్లయితే అభివృద్ధి చెందినటువంటి దేశాల్లో ప్రతి 10,000 మంది జనాభాకి ఒక ఆప్టోమెట్రిస్ట్ ఉంటారు. కానీ మన దేశంలో 600,000 జనాభాకి ఒక ఆప్టోమెట్రిస్ట్ ఉన్నారు అని చెప్పి మనకి తెలియజేస్తుంది. అది ప్రత్యేకించి గ్రామీణ ప్రాంతాల్లో అయితే అది 10,00,000 కూడా ఒక ఆప్టోమెట్రిస్ట్